This lecture is about electrostatic shielding. Most of you know about it. I would just like to take some examples, some problems which I have listed here for you so that you have a better clarity on the problems which come on electrostatic shielding. First of all, we know that if any conductor having a cavity, please note it's a conductor. Conductor has free electrons. If it is placed in an electric field or near a charge, let us take an electric field, means some positive charge is there and parallel electric field is coming because of some charges. Now, the property of this conductor is such that it has enough number of free electrons, and because in presence of electric field, the negative charge will get attracted on this side and positive charge will go towards that side. It remains neutral. If it was initially neutral, it will be finally neutral. If had initially some charge, it will have finally same charge. These are just equal and opposite. Please keep this thing in mind. The induced charges do not add or reduce the total charge of the material or the conductor. So in this case, I have taken that it had no charge and it is placed in electric field. In presence of electric field, electron always moves towards the field. It attacks the electric field and naturally the positive charge will be left on this side. So electron come on this side and positive charge left on that side. And it keeps on happening. This movement of electron keeps on happening till such time in this region as a whole, you are able to oppose. There is an electric field established due to the induced charge. There is an electric field which is already there. If this was not there, some electric field was there. Now, because this is placed in the electric field, induced charge produce their own. This is induced and this is actual. Induced and actual, when they become equal, this movement of electron stops and it attains a stability kind of a thing. So what happens is that there is no electric field in this region. This is the property and this is what is basically referred to as electrostatic shielding, because you have shielded this region. You have shielded this region from this electric field which is there. Similarly, so what is happening is that if you are having some, say, I place some charge here, say on that side, I place some negative charge here. What will happen? Positive charge will come here because electrons will move here and negative will come here. So again, because of the reverse electric field, this electric field is in this direction and the electric field due to that charge is in that direction because it is negative. So electric field neutrality is established here. So there is no net electric field. So this region is blind to this. You keep on moving it around it anywhere. These charges keep on readjusting, but this region is blind to what is happening outside. Now let us take a reverse situation on this system where you have a body and you have some cavity and this is a conductor. Same, it has number of free electrons. That is what makes conductor different from the dielectric. So if you suppose place a positive charge here, plus Q here, suppose it is at the center and negative charge naturally will appear here to make the, because of Gauss law, you will see the electric field here has to be zero and the positive charge will come outside. It may not be uniform in this case because symmetry is not there. And inside symmetry is there, inside it is uniform, it is in the center. Outside it may not be uniform because of the shape. Some pointed shape will have sharp charges. Now, if something is outside, some charge is outside, what does that charge see? Whether the location of this charge inside the shell, its cavity, affects this charge anyway? It doesn't affect. This charge will be now blind to this charge because of this electrostatic shielding. As you see, this is a cavity, I am redrawing it, and this is some positive charge inside and negative charge is appearing here. Its tendency is to make this electric field outside. I have not crossed the boundary. I keep on stretching the boundary of the conductor. Now, this is inside the conductor. This is gauze surface inside the conductor. This negative Q, this sum of this charge will be negative Q, and the gauze surface will have zero flux because the net charge will be zero inside. That is how the charges will reallocate. So you will have electric field zero here. Suppose I keep on stretching the boundary further. I'll be creating a region which is blind to what is here. This region is blind to what is here, and this charge arrangement, whatever was here, is not changing when I am increasing the boundary. What is changing is the outside charge, how it is being allocated. If it is a sphere, then outside charge is always uniform. Only this density will be changing outside. The total charge which is coming on outside because of this electrostatic effect, if this is plus Q here, this was minus Q. I am trying to explain so that you are able to answer different type of questions. Some basic clarity I want. Now, this charge has arranged in such a way that moment you cross this boundary of the inner shell, this is the boundary. This is very important boundary. Moment you cross this boundary, these have no effect on you. These do not have any effect of you on you, these. And till such time you are inside the shell, there is no electric field on you. There are two things. One is effect of this combination of this system, that is charge inside and the induced charge. This is the induced charge. The charge inside and induced charge does not have any effect on you moment you cross the boundary. And moment you cross this boundary, outer boundary, where there is a positive charge, whatever effect you have will be only because of this charge. Because nothing has changed inside. Inside is as it is. And when you are not having anything in this region, because of this arrangement, if you come outside, even the outside the shell, you will not have any effect because of this arrangement. But there is an effect of because of the outer thing. So there will be electric field outside. But that is totally dependent on the outside charge, which is the induced charge outside. So you keep on moving it anywhere inside, the outside charge will remain blind to its movement inside. This is another aspect of the electrostatic shielding. Now let us take some examples, which I think you should find now easy, based on these concepts only. Let us take a sphere and hang a charge inside it with an insulated thread. Now there is a sphere. And you have a cavity here, and there is some scope for me to insert a thread and I hang a charge here. This is the conducting. Conducting means that property you have to use. It's zero electric field inside the conductor and rearrangement of charges, that this boundary, moment you cross this boundary, you are blind to whatever is inside. Now, this is plus Q. What is the, and this is right now at distance R from this point, and there is some point A far away at some, from center it is at a distance R. Now suppose I, now this is situation one. Now situation two is I increase the length of the thread. It is insulated thread, please note. And it is now twice R upon 3. What is the change here in terms of the electric field? No change will happen. Because as I said, this plus Q will have this minus Q here. Wherever you place it, this minus Q will rearrange itself such that once you cross this threshold boundary, you will be blind to it. And your only reaction will be based on the positive induced charge which will come on outside. So it will have no effect on the electric field here, which will depend on this charge, on the movement of the charge inside. But if you increase the charge inside, naturally, the induced charge outside will also increase, the induced charge here will also increase, equal and opposite induced charge will come, electric field will change. So, same thing which I have said earlier, I am just saying in form of a question so that it becomes easy to comprehend. Now, let me take another example and let me take this kind of a conductor. And there is a spherical cavity inside. At the center, I place charge Q0. Here, I place charge Q. Or Q1 or Q2, whatever. Outside the conductor. What is the force on Q0 and what is the force on Q? As far as Q0 is concerned, it will induce negative Q0 here, but it is placed right now at the center, symmetry is there. So whatever attraction will be there in terms of this is all nullified. So there is no force due to its own induced charge, first of all, when it is at center. Now, once you come outside it, you are blind. You have become blind to what is happening inside. Now here there is a positive charge. There is a positive charge here. So, and the pattern will depend on the shape here. This charge will see only this. This will see only this charge and it will experience some force which will be proportional to this Q0. And that distance which is there, inversely proportional to that distance. I'm just writing, not because I can't, you can't calculate, you will have to see that detailed calculation is also not in the scope. We are just doing the conceptual part. Now that is as far as that Q is concerned. Now look at what is happening on this conductor because of this Q. Because of this Q, which is positive, you will have negative induced charge here. Now this is the charge I am showing. First layer I showed the induced charge because of the inside charge. And the second layer I am showing the induced charge because of that. And you will have a positive charge here. Now these induced charges are to be such that electric field because of this charge here is nullified. Electric field due to this charge is to be nullified by these charges. They have to nullify the electric field. So this rearrangement is based on that hypothesis that it has to be nullified because you can't have any electric field here anyway. So whatever may be here, the charges will keep on rearranging to nullify its electric field. So this inside charge, as I said, is blind to it. Blind to Q1. Like Q1 was blind to Q0, Q0 is blind to Q1. But there is a difference. Q1 had a force because of this. Q0 will not have any force. Q0 will not have any force. It is equally located from this induced charge. So force on Q0 will, it is located at center, I repeat, and it's a conductor. So force on Q0 is 0 and force on Q1 is that. So that is this problem. Now let us take another problem. There is a sphere which has a charge. This is now a spherical cavity. And some charge plus Q is placed here. There is an electric field here. What is the direction of force in this shell? This shell is suppose A. What will be the direction of force on this shell? Now see what is happening. This is plus Q here. Some intense minus will be here and some less minus, scattered minus will be there. It will be more intense here. And it will be like this here. So this is how it is. Because this charge minus Q has to nullify this charge to make the electric field here 0. So electric field here is 0. So moment I have crossed this boundary, I am now blind to whatever arrangement is here. And it is minus, minus have come here. So naturally plus charge has to come outside. And since outside is a uniform curved surface, and once you cross this boundary, it is immaterial where you place the charge. You keep on rotating the charge. I am blind to this. But a positive charge has to come there because negative has come here. Because negative has come here, positive charge has to come outside. But how that positive charge will come outside is blind to the arrangement inside. So only aspect which will determine the alignment of the charge outside is the outer boundary. If it is a sphere, it's a uniform kind of thing, this charge will remain uniform. Now this is the direction of electric field. And this is a positive charge. So what happens? If this electric field is also seeing only this much. Why it has this boundary, outside this boundary, everybody is blind. So blind, I am not saying in a derogatory sense. I am saying blind means I am not able to see that. So the force here will be E times Q, because Q is the charge which is coming here. So it will experience a force in the right direction. But this will not experience force because of this electric field. There is no force on Q because of this E. Please note, I am not saying there is no net force on Q. There is no force on Q because of this E, because it has been shielded because of this property of movement of free electrons. So this is what electrostatic shielding is, and I will try to see that if I am able to locate more interesting problems. Yeah, one more problem is there, which I think, yes, I should take. Now, we have a situation where In this problem, what is given is a inner radius is small r, outer radius is capital R, and you have a positive charge inside, and this is distance to R, and you have a positive Q placed outside. We have to find what is the net force on Q. First of all, what will be the net force on Q? First of all, this is a conductor. Q is placed at the center. Q is positive, so negative charge will come here. This is symmetrical, so Q is not experiencing any force due to this arrangement. It is at the center. Outside it, there is no electric field because of this, and a positive charge will naturally appear outside because of the inside. These are all induced charges, and this first layer I am showing because of the induced charge of the inside charge. Induced charge which is emerging because of the inside charge. Now this plus Q will also produce an induced charge which I will show by second layer. Here it will be negative. And here it will be positive. Now this induced charge produces one electric field which is induced, and there is one electric field because of Q. It is EQ. As I have said, I am just repeating, but just so that it will be more clear, the electric field inside has to be zero because of the induced charge, and this means once you cross this outer boundary, this boundary, the impact of this Q is not seen because these charges have nullified. This is shielded. This inside is shielded. So Q doesn't have any impact because of capital Q, and Q doesn't have any impact because of its own induced charges because of the symmetry. So there is no net force on Q. Now the second question is, what is the force on this small Q due to the induced charges? And what is the direction? It's simple. What is the electric field here? Had this sphere not been there because of this, the electric field here would have been Q upon 4 pi epsilon twice R whole square because of this. And electric field induced has to be equal and opposite, minus and opposite. So it will be in the opposite direction. This is the electric field had this not been there. Electric field due to this is in this direction. Now induced electric field has to be in this direction, but magnitude has to be same, 4 pi epsilon twice R whole square. So what is the, please, question has to be seen very carefully. What is the force due to the induced charge? The force due to induced charge will be this. The induced charge, electric field due to induced charge times the charge is the force due to induced charge. And electric field due to induced charge, this charge, it will be same but opposite direction as the electric field due to this at this point. So this way you can approach these problems. I hope it was useful.